grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Christina died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with her eternal glory. Chris and Barbara, please. If you return to our hymn books, we'll sing together number 131.
To me, His word, my.
community of St. Maximilian Kolbe and this Church of Holy Spirit, I, Peter Wright, wish to offer to Christina's family our condolences and assure you we've been praying for Christina and for yourselves and will, of course, continue to do so. I presume that you are Christina? Yep, super. We're still missing Francis and Helen. They seem to be stuck in traffic.
No,
but we...
They're not coming.
They're not coming. Okay, so we're all right then. But we do have Kevin and Catherine. And also, did I write it down? I didn't. Maxine? Phew, I remembered. They're amazed I remembered, I can assure you. So welcome to this celebration in which we desire to offer to God our prayers for Christina on her journey. In a moment of quiet, we pause to allow the Spirit of God to speak hope of the kingdom of life to us, and I will lead us in prayer. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son, who died on the cross, was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery, your servant Christina, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask it through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Would you please sit down? We now listen to reading from the scripture, which again reminds us of our Christian hope, and Linda will read for us.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Think of the love that the Father has lavished on us by letting us be called God's children. And that is what we are. Because the world refused to acknowledge him, therefore it does not acknowledge us. My dear people, we are already the children of God. But what we are to be in the future has not yet been revealed. All we know is that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, because we shall see him as he really is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. And we always respond to the reading by singing a psalm. So if you turn to 661.
Healing.
Please stand to greet the words of Jesus.
Alleluia. 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 Alleluia.
It is my Father's will, says the Lord, that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the crowd, "All that the Father gives me will come to me, and whoever comes to me, I shall not turn him away, because I have come from heaven, not to do my own will, but to do the will of the one who sent me. Now, the will of him who sent me is that I should lose nothing of all that he has given to me, and that I should raise it up on the last day. Yes, it is my Father's will that whoever sees the Son and believes in him shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day." The Gospel of the Lord. Would you please sit down? Again, it will be no surprise to the parishioners that it was last night I remembered who Christina was. I was thinking, I know her. I've seen her lots of times. Why can't I remember her? Pandemic had. I apologise. Okay? That's my excuse. Pandemic had. Remember the friends that you used to sit with as well? It all came flooding back, finally. And many of the parishioners remember Christina with much love and respect, and especially her involvement with the First Friday group. Not able to do it at the moment, but the best guns in the world. So, you know, we can buy them for you, send you one, but they're not available at the moment. There'll be many other memories of Christina. Certainly it was shared with me that she was Irish and fiery Irish. There's only one sort, isn't there? These ladies will have a word with me later on. It's true. But also that she was a shopper. Not a clue what that means. Avoid shopping at any cost. And the great love of Christina to be with us for the celebrations of Mass. Really, really great to finally cottoned on to who she is. And I say she is because her physical body is no longer bursting with life, is no longer fiery, but the person, the spirit, the soul, continues on the journey to the kingdom. It struck me that as I was looking through the hymns that Christina had chosen, that they do recognise we need a saviour. A funeral mass is a prayer to the Father for the deceased, knowing we need the saviour, the Lord Jesus, who lived and died for us. And the readings that I chose to support the hymns also remind us of the strength of our faith. It's not so long ago that we were keeping Christmas. The crib was just over there. Jesus, born into poverty, the Son of God, the Son of Mary, totally human, totally divine. That's fantastic in itself. But the flip side, the divine reversal, is that this happened so we can become divine. not a shade, not a bit, not a reflection, so we can become divine. That's the journey we're on in life. It's the journey that Christina continues on with our prayers, to become divine. The first reading, it's absolutely stunning. And the strength of the words does remind us of how important we reflect on this. Love is lavished upon us by God. Most of you are parents, you lavish love on your children, your grandchildren. There's nothing compared to the love of the eternal. So we have to always magnify the love. And this love is lavished, so we're recognized as children of God. Do we have to do anything? We say yes in baptism, and we strive to say yes through our lives. But we cannot earn this love. It's a free gift poured upon us. And then John continues. It's a bit difficult in the world. It's very difficult in the world at the moment. What's going to happen in the future? We shall be like him. We shall be God. Because we shall see God as God really is. And again, not a shade, not a fraction, not a shadow. The full glory of God is revealed to us, and it's overwhelming, absolutely overwhelming. The Christians have heard me talk about Psalm 23 many times, but if you really pause and later on at communion, if you want to use it as a reflection, please do look again at the words, because it says Christina's journeying to a heavenly banquet. She's been shepherded throughout her life. And the shepherd in the east walks ahead. The people follow. The sheep follow. We're with him, but he walks ahead. We're not wrapped in candy floss, otherwise we wouldn't be human. Any child that's spoiled becomes a pretty dreadful adult. We have to be human and endure what is difficult in life in the company of the shepherd. But what the shepherd prepares for us in the eternal kingdom is the banquet. And we have just sung, he prepares the banquet. It is, for sure, the Eucharist that we're here to celebrate, but it is also the heavenly banquet. Being aware that God loves us more than you, wonderful love for your children and your grandchildren. What kind of cook is God? Amazing. Absolutely amazing. He prepares a banquet for us to feast upon. It's beautiful, beautifully imagery for us that we can really get hold of. And then the Gospel of John, it's full again of certitude as to what the will of God always is. And he says to us three times, I lose nothing of whatever is given to me. Those who say yes to Jesus are never lost. This looks like loss because our human sight is limited. But Christina journeys with Jesus into the eternal kingdom. And he says again and again, I shall raise them up. It's an imperative, not maybe, perhaps. I shall. This is going to happen. I will raise them up on the last day. They shall, because that's stronger, they shall have eternal life. All of our symbolism as Catholics reminds us of this, our truth. The pall is wrapped around Christina's coffin as the shawl of baptism. From that second, we begin the journey to become divine. And we're reminded of this. The cross, because we're human, he suffered and endured as the divine son, but the human son of Mary. And the gospel book, the words of Jesus that lift us up in hope. I shall give you eternal life. I shall raise you up on the last day. We're all affected by society around us, and many films I've seen, they present death in a most bizarre way. And I just go, that's not our Christian understanding. Our Christian understanding is represented by the Easter candle. Jesus, the light. The eternal light is there in the second of death, from the second of baptism. Jesus the light is there continually. As Christina dies, she's guided in the company of the light to the eternal kingdom. There's nothing vague or distant about it. It is always intimate and close with the person of Jesus Christ, the light of the world. So as we continue in a moment with prayers for Christina and for yourselves, let us be reminded of all that the shepherd has done for us, all the shepherd offers us and Christina. And let's all again say a huge yes to the person of the Son of God and Son of Mary. If you'd like to stand, Elizabeth will lead us in our universal prayer, and at the end of each she will say, Lord, in your mercy, and our response is, hear our prayer. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead. With confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Christina, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For our sister, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For the family and friends of our sister Christina, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
As we gather in the house of our eternal Father, we offer our personal prayers in a moment of quiet. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed sister Christina. Cleanse her and all the faithful departed of their sins. Grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Would you please sit down? And if Brian and Kate would help us with the gifts, please, or is Claire going to do it? Claire, okay. And our next hymn is 529. Would you please stand? Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of the Lord in his name, for our good and for the glory of the Church.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Christina, we beseech your mercy that she, who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Saviour, may find in him a merciful Judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with those in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Saviour of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. If you'd like to sit down. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your Church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Mark our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Christina, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed sisters and brothers too, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the kingdom, all glory and honour is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
We stand together. We're going to use the words that Jesus taught us 2 millennia ago, the words that unite us here to pray for the kingdom, but also the church around the world, and also the church journeying to the kingdom like Christina, and all those praying fully in the kingdom of light. So with this vast number of Christians, we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever."
Amen.
With the sign of peace, with the words, we normally exchange a handshake, because of the situation with the pandemic, we're not able to do that. But what we can do is offer each other peace be with you. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. And now we pray together. Lamb of God. Would you like to sit there? Behold, the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. For those who are not able to receive communion with us this morning, I'd encourage you to come forward for a blessing. So if you'd like a blessing, place your hand on your own shoulder. you'd now like to turn to 628 for our communion song. This is a short reflection written by Maxim. You always had a smile to share, time to give and time to care. A wonderful nature, warm and true. You were my special friend and I really do miss you. Let us stand to pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Christina, who has journeyed from this world, may by this sacrifice be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. We ask it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
If I can have Chris and Barbara, please. Trusting in God, we pray together for Christina. Now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Christina again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Once again, I sprinkle Christina's coffin with the water of baptism, the water of new life, and then honour it with the use of incense, recognising she was literally a temple of the Holy Spirit.
I know that my Redeemer lives, and on that final day of days, his voice shall bid me rise again, unending joy, unceasing praise. This hope I cherish in my heart, to stand on earth, my flesh restored, and not a stranger, but a friend. Behold my Saviour and my Lord.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Christina in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our sister forever. We ask it through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'm sure I can express your thanks to the community for joining us and praying with you for Christina. So thank you very much. In peace, let us take Christina to her place of rest. And as we leave church this morning, we'll sing 141.
Thank you.